I got stuck.
Okay, now just introduce yourself to everyone. Just tell everyone your circumstances, bro.
Okay, hi. The name is Togozani Tsiko. What had happened was, this was the worst experience ever. On my way to school, the car just ran out of petrol. Behind me, there's so many cars hooting and just they wanna pass, and I didn't know what to do at that moment in time. So what I did is come out of the car and then push it. While I was pushing it, this guy right here that's recording this actually helped me out. And yeah, now we're about to go get petrol and then back to my car. Which, okay, lesson for the day is, I'm so excited, but at the same time I'm so stressed because there's a lot of things to do. Lesson of the day is, no matter what the struggle is, no matter where you are, who you are, or whatever you're going through, just make sure to lend a help. Stuttering. Are you gonna?
Hey, yeah, I'm gonna edit it, bro. Yeah.
Just make sure to put in what you call this?
Lend a helping hand.
Lend a helping hand.
That's
at
it.
Any given day to anyone, however the situation might be, because you never know if it might come back for you.
That's
and
it.
Blessings on top of blessings. And thank you for putting me in the
hectic. Okay, cool.
Flip, bro.
Sorted.
This is 50 rand, by the way.
Yes.
As you can see.
You're 50 bucks.
Dude, I can't wait to get back to the car.
Oh, that's perfect, bro.
You back at it again.
How many liters?
Huh?
I'm losing liters every time I drop a drop.
True.
Ooh.
Okay, you sorted.
Thanks again. I'll
wait.
Yo, better days to come. Stay blessed.
I'll wait.
And future endeavors. future what? Future prosperity.
That's it. Cheers, boss.
Yeah, stay blessed.
I'll see you, man. Shot. Okay, that's sorted. So now it's time to get going.
He's a happy chap. He's sorted with his car. And let this be a lesson, guys. If you see anyone stranded on the side of the road, you can even use that as a metaphor. If you see someone struggling, lend a helping hand, because you never know when you'll need it as well. So yeah, guys, I'm off now, and I will see you guys in whatever clip I take next.
I run away for some time until the universe is satisfied. I run away for some time until the universe is sensitized. Word is on my mind, and there's crowding on my senses. Care to redefine, and there's crowding on my senses. Yeah.
Shaun and I just finished up the workout, guys. Shaun, what are your thoughts on the workout?
Personally, I think Keegan is a great personal trainer. All you need to gain muscle is big plates and big weights. That's it, boys.
What must I do? Am I supposed to say something?
You just have to introduce yourself.
Hi, guys.
Yeah, I'll just say who you are.
I'm Caitlin. I'm Keegan's cousin. What else? Oh, we just got a two-page scope for psychology.
Okay. For what?
For psychology.
When are we writing?
Next week.
Next week when?
Am I even in this thing? Like, I'm so short.
Yeah. Is there anything else you want to add?
No.
Okay, thanks.
What's up, guys? So it's the next day and I'm on my way home from varsity. Just wanted to introduce my cousin Caitlin to you guys. I asked her if she wanted to be in the video. That was a random video you saw in my last clip. I'm on my way home now. I don't want to face the camera towards my face because then I focus on the camera, then I don't focus on the road. That can lead to an accident. That's not what we want. Behind me, there's these people in a red car that are just like waving at me non-stop. I don't know who they are. I probably do know them, but I just can't see who they are, so... Yeah, but yeah, what you guys basically saw was a lackluster workout with my boy Shaun. That guy is an absolute animal. I see such potential in this guy. Like this guy is gonna make an impact. He's gonna make a huge impact, guys. Just watch this space. What time is it now? It's 11:45, which means that I need to get ready to train. Yeah, guys, I'll check in with you guys a little bit later. And thanks for tuning in. Okay, I think. Did you notice the car? Yeah. Yeah.
I think we should drive.
Yeah. Where are we now?
Detention. Can't drive.
Yo, 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 guys. I think the last clip that I posted was of Shaun and I in the gym, in the NMU gym. I think it was like a back workout or something. And I just want to talk to you guys about the whole coronavirus outbreak and, you know, how we can incorporate the word of God into this whole pandemic. So basically, guys, what I want to talk to you about is a few verses that I have really, really taken to heart that can maybe help you guys as well to get through this whole coronavirus pandemic and, you know, the stress that the whole world is putting onto you on a daily basis, whether it be through the news or whether it be through articles or whatever the case may be. So I just want to share with you guys from Psalm 91, and I'm just going to read from verse 1 all the way down to verse 60. So those who live in shelter of the Most High will find rest in the shadow of the Almighty. This I declare of the Lord. He alone is my refuge, my place of safety. He is my God, and I'm trusting in him. For he will rescue you from every trap and protect you from the fatal plague. He will shield you with his wings. He will shelter you with his feathers. His faithful promises are your armor and protection. Do not be afraid of the terrors of the night, nor fear the dangers of the day, nor dread the plague that stalks in darkness, nor the disaster that strikes at midday. Though 1,000 fall at your side, though 10,000 are dying around you, these evils will not touch you, but you will see it with your eyes. You will see how the wicked are punished. If you make the Lord your refuge, if you make the Most High your shelter, no evil will conquer you. No plague will come near your dwelling, for he orders his angels to protect you wherever you go. They will hold you in their hands to keep you from striking your foot on a stone. You will trample down lions and poisonous snakes. You will crush fierce lions and serpents under your feet. The Lord says, I will rescue those who love me. I will protect those who trust in my name. When they call me, I will answer. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue them and honor them. I will satisfy them with a long life and give them my salvation. So, first of all, I just want to make a clear statement that just because we are Christians doesn't mean that we are immune to any type of virus or, you know, in this case, the coronavirus. But what it does mean is that through prayer and through understanding God's word, we are able to break through the stigma of this is going to kill us and the fear of this whole outbreak as a whole. So basically, my point with this whole message is to just emphasize that prayer is so important, guys. Like,
The power of prayer is just unimaginably important. I was in my pastor's sermon, was it yesterday? What day is it today? It's Monday. Yes, yesterday, last night. Yeah, shout out to Pastor Trevor from Lighthouse Church. Ho 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 ho. What a G. Pastor Trev spoke about how important prayer is. And, you know, God isn't just letting these things happen for nothing. He wants to see that we are actually praying for, you know, for things to get better. He wants to know that we know that He is Lord and Savior by us praying for things. God isn't just sending these things out to us and saying, okay, now you guys deal with it yourselves. I'm going to sit back on my chair and watch it all happen. He's waiting for us to take that first step to pray about things in order for Him to say, okay, my child, I'll listen to what you say now and I'm going to conquer it. But in order to do that, we have to take that first step in faith. So that's basically my whole message of what I want to share with you guys about how important prayer is. Just on that note, guys, please remember that God is always with us. There's no sleeping for Him. He doesn't sleep and say, okay, now guys, set my alarm for 5 a.m. Maybe 5 a.m. is a bit too early. Okay, cool, 7 a.m. maybe, but if like, you know, I might hit the snooze button, I might, you know, oh, the pillow is so comfortable. None of that. He's saying that He doesn't sleep. He does not sleep a wink, and He'll always make sure that He's providing for us. So whether it be the viruses, whether it be a plague of locusts, as you guys have seen in Africa, it doesn't matter what is going on. He is always with us, and I can't stress that enough, but that's basically my whole message to you guys today. And this is just to end off the video on such a positive note and for you guys to realize that Jesus is Lord and He's going to save us all, and He is coming. He's coming very soon. So you guys best be ready. Please be ready. In everything you do, just praise Him, because there's no other words to describe it. Like, He's coming. He's the second coming is near. So it can be in the next 10 years. It can be in the next day. It can be in the next 5 months. All we need to know is we need to be ready. So, yes, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. And I just want to say God bless, and much more content coming soon. Just apologize for the delay in the videos. It won't always be like this. I'm actually going on a break now because of the whole coronavirus outbreak. The universities have taken a stand to close for like a certain period of time, and then including the recess period, which is great. My assignments and tests have been postponed. So I'd just like to give a shout out to my boy Mike for always supporting me. Michael Coates, guys. I just want to say, guys, thanks for tuning in to the video. And this light has been shining in my face for the past 5 minutes and it's quite sore. So I'm gonna take a breather and I'll see you guys in the next video. So peace.